This used to be AI dancing, but thanks to Kling 2.6 motion control, I can finally make my AI characters dance for real. I was a ghost, I was alone. Kling 2.6 motion control lets you transfer real dance motion onto an AI character, including the expressions and camera movements, while still giving you control of the dynamic backgrounds like this. After I posted this short, a lot of you asked how I made it. So in this video, I'll show you the exact workflow, how I use Kling 2.6 motion control, and how I stitch everything together into the final clip. Let's get started. First, let's start with the setup. To create this video, we're going to use OpenArt. Before jumping into video generation, I want to quickly show you how I prepare my characters. Under image, I go to create image. For model, I am using Nano Banana Pro as the image model. So in Omni reference, we toggle this on. I uploaded my character image I have from my previous K-pop music video. As you can see, this original image does not have a proper bottom half. To fix that, I actually grabbed reference images from K-pop Demon Hunter's concert outfit online, and I screenshotted the shorts and the boots here. In the prompt, I specify full body shot of the woman, white short as in the reference image, white boots, and also model proportion. Now here in the settings, since I want this video to be vertical, I set the aspect ratio to be 9:16. Selected 2K resolution, choose how many images you want to generate, and click create. This gives me the full body image that I can use as my character reference like this. This one accidentally added concert stage in the background, and I think it will be interesting to see if the crowd in the background can be animated. You'll sometimes get a strange proportion like this. That's why being explicit in the prompt can really help. Once the character images are ready, we can move on to the video. Under video, we go to motion sync. And up top, you'll see that there are several models available here. But today we're using Kling 2.6, which is the only model I think can handle the high energy dance that we're trying to get to for this one. But I will generate the other ones for comparison, just for your entertainment. In this first slot, you can choose your character from the OpenArt character. So from here, you can just drag your image in this box. In the second step, we need to add a motion reference. This one is a video with a dance motion. And down here, we will keep the original sound. We want the music to be included. And under motion reference control, we actually have two options. Exact matches the camera movement and the character facing from the motion reference. You can use clips up to 30 seconds for this one. Partial transfers the motion only and lets you control camera movement and character facing with prompts. This model is limited to 10 seconds. I will test both for you to see the differences. And for video mode, we can see there's a standard and pro. Standard outputs at 720p and it is said to work well for simpler motion, while pro gives you 1080p and it can handle fast and high energy dance better. I'll test both of them so you can compare as well. And under here, we can use the prompt box to describe additional elements beyond the motion itself. For example, in some of the videos, I prompted for fireworks and smoke in the background. So you can see like dynamic background like this. Original image was actually not a concert scene. And Kling can introduce and evolve the background based on your prompt. Once everything looked good, we click create to generate the video. I was a ghost, I was alone. 두어진 기 속에. Here's the result using exact motion reference with the pro model. You can see that the camera movement closely follows the reference video, including the slow push in and pull up. The motions are pretty smooth and stable. Even without prompting the background, you can see people are moving naturally as well. So the models know what are supposed to move in the background. This one is the exact motion reference with standard, and the motion still follows the character well, but you'll notice more morphing, especially around the hands, where when they overlap, and some facial details are less defined. Also note that the standard output is 720p. It's not as sharp as the pro version. Also, I didn't prompt anything, but there's some weird stuff happening in the background. And moving on, this is the partial motion reference with standard. Since I didn't prompt any camera movement, the camera stays pretty static compared to the previous one, but there's still some movement. And you'll also notice the motion is less defined overall because it's a standard version and there's a higher chance of morphing as well. the partial motion reference with Pro. Because it's Pro, the details hold up better and less morphing, but as well because it's partial, so it only copied the movement. It didn't capture the camera motion from the reference video. So for this version, I added a prompt for a 360 degree camera orbit around the character, which gives it a really dynamic result. You can control the camera movement like this when you select the partial for motion reference control. This is a vaguer prompt that didn't really give any proper camera movement. So it's best to use cinematography language that to write something like this. I also experimented with prompts like concert stage lights flashing and fireworks exploding in the background, and you get things like this. And for this one, I tried disco ball reflection, purple and cyan concert lighting. So it actually listened pretty well to the prompt. This one I added crowds cheering with raised hands and smoke machine creating atmosphere. I was a ghost, I was alone. So this one is just for comparison. I tested OpenArt motion. It roughly followed the dance, it just doesn't dance as well, and also it's not as smooth and it's not as clean when you compare it with the Kling 2.6 version. I was a ghost, I was alone. For this kind of high intensity dance, Runway Act 2 is not even playing in the same league. To make the video that I have in my example, we'll generate a bunch of them in different background, or like in my case, different characters with the same driving video. We'll choose the exact motion reference and the pro for every single one of them. Later we can combine them together and sync them in a way that makes sense to the kind of video I show in the beginning. We go to a video editor like CapCut. First you put the reference video down here as the base, other clips on top, and to make sure that they are all sync at the same time, we select all of them and right click, and then we can click sync video and audio. This way we make sure they are all matched by the audio. We can adjust the scale of each clip. Sometimes you have to make sure it covers the whole border. And from here we can start to cut and decide which clip to reveal. So for example, for transition, I usually cut on the moment with fast movement, for example, like spin or sharp actions. Those timing makes transition feel more smooth. We can do it here. We can cut this one and reveal this part, like this. Cut here and reveal this part. For example, we show this part and then this part and this part, this part and then this one. And this is how easy it is to create this type of transition. You just have to cut at the right fast-paced moment. Again, all the clips I'm using here are generated with exact motion reference, so the camera movement and the character positioning stay consistent, which make the transition feel more natural. So after this, it's just a matter of choosing which moment to show, and you can export the video and then you're done. I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you want more tutorial like this. I'll include the prompts I use below. If you want to go deeper into creative AI workflows like this, I also have a free community where we talk through these experiments together. Thanks to Kling 2.6, I finally made my dancing dream come true. Also, check out this video to learn how to make AI K-pop music video. I was a ghost, I was alone. Given the throne, I didn't know how to believe.